In this lesson, we're going to talk more about the slope of a line, which remember is the slant or the inclination of the line. And in a past lesson, we were able to determine the slope by looking at the graph and counting blocks, vertical change over horizontal change. We were able to determine the slope if we knew the ordered pairs for two points using the formula. But now we're going to look and see that we can find the slope of a line by just looking at the equation. It turns out that the equation of a line is usually in the form, get my pen writing, y equals mx plus b. Or it can be in this form. We can get equations of lines so that they say y equals. All right, when you do get an equation in the form y equals, the coefficient of x, which I'm calling letter m, is actually the slope of the line. It's a number just sitting there waiting. That's the slope. The constant number is the y-intercept. In this lesson, I'm not really going to do anything with this y-intercept because I'm just focused on slope. But I will in a future lesson. So, if I have the equation of a line and I can get it in the form y equals, then the coefficient of x is the slope. Let's see how we do that. Problem number one, I have y equals 2x minus 9. Is it in the right format? The answer is yes, because the right format is y equals. Y equals mx plus b. There's the value of m. So the slope is 2. Just 2. It's great. It was given to us. Next problem. We have y equals negative 0.8x plus 8.2. Is this equation in the right format? Yes, it says y equals mx plus b. Well, here's the slope. Because the instructions say to type as an integer or a decimal, I can just take that decimal and the answer is negative 0.8. Honestly, it is more common to use a fractional value. So negative 8/10 reducing to negative 4/5 would be my preferred answer, but these instructions say to give a decimal, so we will. The next one, I have x plus y equals 4. This one is not in the right format because it is not y by itself. I'm going to use a skill that I learned earlier about manipulating a formula. I want y by itself, which means I need to get rid of this x term that's added. So I will subtract the x term. Positive x and negative x, those are opposites. So I have y equals. Now these are not like terms. Although some people would like to write 4 minus x, which is correct, in this lesson, we want to put it in y equals mx plus b format. So I need these reversed. Y is equal to, the x is negative, so negative x, positive 4. This is in y equals mx plus b format. What's the value of m? There's an implied negative 1 right there. So the slope is negative 1. We have to be able to get the formula. We have to be able to modify it so that it says y equals. Let's do a few more. These will be a little more involved. I have 6x minus 7y is 42. I'm asked for the slope. Well, the slope is not obvious because it doesn't say y equals. To get it so it says y equals, I'll need to get rid of that x term. That's gone. I have negative 7y is equal to, let's put these in order, negative 6x and positive 42. I have to divide by the coefficient, which is negative 7. Divide everything by negative 7. That gives me positive y is equal to. Now, the coefficient of x is negative 6 over negative 7. But negative over negative is positive, so I'm just going to put 6 sevenths x. Positive divided by negative is negative 6. The slope is the fraction 6 sevenths. All right, the next one is somewhat similar. I have negative 4x minus 7y is equal to 5. I want y by itself, so I'm going to add 4x to both sides, doing the opposite. That leaves me with negative 7y is equal to, putting these in the order I like, positive 4x and positive 5. Divide everything by negative 7. And y is equal to, you can leave it just like this if you want, 4 over negative 7x minus 5 over 7. And there's the slope. You could type in 4 over negative 7, or you could type in negative 4 over 7 because they are equal, or you could have 4 sevenths and you could have the negative sign out in front of the fraction, whichever one you want. They are all equivalent. All right, last one. Let's see, I have 10x minus 5y is equal to 6.2, and I want y by itself. Remember, I want things in y equals mx plus b format. So I need to subtract 10x. That leaves me with negative 5y is equal to, these are not like terms, so all I can do is write negative 10x plus 6.2, divide by negative 5, and y is equal to, negative divided by negative is positive 2, this will be minus, and I'm going to grab my calculator, 6.2 divided by 5 gives me 1.24. Now, in this particular setting, this number is not relevant because I'm asked one and only one thing, what's the slope? And the slope is 2. Okay? So, that's how you find the slope of a line if you're given an equation. So, we can find the slope if we have ordered pairs using a formula. We can find the slope from a graph counting vertical change over horizontal change. But if we have an equation, then we get it in the form y equals mx plus b, and the coefficient of x is the slope.